"How will you carry me?" asked the boy.
"You'll have to sit straddle on my shoulders and put your arms around my neck. Do you think you can keep from falling off?"
"I'll try," said Button Bright. So the Ork squatted down and the boy took his seat and held on tight. Then the skinny creature's tail began whirling, and up they went, far above all the treetops. After the Ork had circled around once or twice, its sharp eyes located the towers of the castle, and away it flew straight toward the place. As it hovered in the air nearby the castle, Button Bright pointed out Pon's hut, so they landed just before it and Trot came running out to greet them. Gloria was introduced to the Ork, who was surprised to find Cap'n Bill transformed into a grasshopper.
"How do you like it?"
asked the creature.
"Why, it worries me a good deal,"
answered Cap'n Bill, perched upon Trot's shoulder.
"I'm always afraid of being stepped on, and I don't like the flavor of grass, and can't seem to get used to it. It's my nature to eat grass, you know, but I begin to suspect it's an acquired taste." "Can you give molasses?"
asked the Ork.
"I guess I'm not that kind of grasshopper,"
replied Cap'n Bill.
"But I can't say what I might do if I was squeezed, which I hope I won't be." "Well," said the Ork, "it's a great pity, and I'd like to meet that cruel king and his wicked witch, and punish them both severely. You're awfully small, Cap'n Bill, but I think I would recognize you anywhere by your wooden leg."
Then the Ork and Button Bright were told all about Gloria's frozen heart, and how the Scarecrow had come from the Land of Oz to help them. The Ork seemed rather disturbed when it learned that the Scarecrow had gone alone to conquer King Krule.